All right, moving on. In this next segment, the next few videos, we're going to explore some ways to make your video look more professional, more clean and polished. The first thing we're going to cover is transitions, which are built-in animations you add to the beginning or end of a piece of media that affect how it enters or exits the video. You can find transitions up here in the Transitions tab, right under the Annotations. As with most everything else in this pane, when you click on an item, you'll get a preview of what each transition does. Now, the first one's a bit of an oddity. It's an audio transition, but we'll talk about that in a later tutorial. In this tutorial, we're just going to deal with these video ones. The transition I use the most, by far, is the fade in out transition. Mostly because it's very smooth, clean, and not distracting. I do use the others, but for very specific reasons, such as to convey a change in location or a significant passage of time, things like that. Remember that everything you add to your video will communicate something, so just be aware of how your viewers may interpret what you choose. Okay, let's start at the very beginning where I have a title slide to introduce the video's topic. Then it jumps right into the recording. That jump is a little harsh, so let's add the fade transition to the end of the title slide. Notice that when I start dragging the transition down, only the ends of the clips highlight instead of the entire clips, as they do with animations, effects, etc. This looks better. It fades nicely to black, which is the canvas color. But then the recording jumps back on. So let's add a fade to that as well. Ah, that looks much nicer. A fade through black. We could also create what's called a crossfade by overlapping the fades of these two clips. Just drag the end of the image to make it longer to about right here. See how it snaps? And now when we play it back, the video fades nicely from one into the other. Another area where I want to add a transition is at this annotation. It just suddenly appears, then suddenly disappears. So just as we did before, drag the fade transition to the front, and then one to the back. When we preview it, notice the arrow doesn't seem to stay on the screen for very long. So we can either lengthen out the clip, or shorten how long the transitions last by dragging the inside edges of the transitions and making them smaller. Sometimes zooming in on the timeline with this slider makes dragging items that are close together a bit easier. And there we go. Before we end, I'll share a tip that will save you a lot of time. Since I want to have all of my annotations fade in and out, I could add a fade to each end of each one. But the easiest way to do that is to first select all of the annotations and clips you want to fade in and out, hold down Shift on your keyboard, clicking on all the clips so that they're blue, then dragging a fade to the beginning of one clip, then one to the end. As you can see, all of them now have fades. This works for all of the transitions. Well, that should be good enough to get you started. Take some time now to add transitions to your project. Experiment with the different kinds and lengths of transitions to see how they affect your video. As always, you can download the example project if you don't have your own. And I'll see you in the next tutorial, where we'll continue to go over ways to make your video look more polished. Specifically, we'll cover using animations to add interest.